In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We gather in worship of the Lord this morning as we continue to celebrate the Eucharist in this very special way that's been set aside for us, and to prepare ourselves to celebrate together, both here and across the nation. Let us call to mind our sins, and we ask God's forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, peace incarnate, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, justice for all people. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, quiet in the storm. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who taught by the Holy Spirit, we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. At the mountain of God, Horeb, Elijah came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said to him, "Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord. The Lord will be passing by." A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak and went and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord.
See your kindness, Lord, let us see your kindness, your kindness and salvation. Grant us, O Lord, Lord, let us see your kindness, Lord, let us see your kindness, your kindness and salvation. Grant us, O Lord. I will hear what the Lord proclaims, peace and salvation close at hand. Always near to those who fear Him, glory dwelling in our land. Lord, let us see your kindness. Let us see your kindness and salvation. Grant us, O Lord, kindness and truth shall meet at last, justice and peace embrace in love. Truth shall spring up from the earth, and justice shall look down from heaven above. Lord, let us see your kindness. Lord, let us see your kindness, your kindness and salvation. Grant us, O Lord. God will grant abundant grace, earth will spring up with boundless life. Blessings flow ever before Him to prepare His way. Lord, let us see His kindness. Lord, let us see your kindness, your kindness and salvation. Grant us, O Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I speak the truth in Christ. I do not lie. My conscience joins with the Holy Spirit in hearing me witness that I have great sorrow and constant anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from the Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites, heirs to the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. They are the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, is the Christ, who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord. Thank you.
wait for the Lord. My soul waits for his word. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. After he had fed the people, Jesus made the disciples get into a boat and precede him to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. When it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, he came forward toward them, walking on the sea. When his disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said, and they cried out in fear. At once, Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." Jesus said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened. And beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus stretched out his hand and caught Peter and said to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Today's gospel, the calming of the waters. Well, this is actually the second time in Matthew's gospel that he has calmed the waters. This is in chapter 14, but back in chapter 8, he also calms the waters. This is a time, not when he comes walking across the water in chapter 8. Jesus is sleeping in the boat, and they're going across the Sea of Galilee. It's 5, 6, 7 miles wide, and it's a fairly long trip in a little boat that you have to half push and half hope for the wind. But anyway, in the first one, Jesus is sleeping, and a storm comes up, and the waters are being tossed, and Jesus just sleeps right through it, until finally they wake him up and say, "Lord, you know, we're going to die. What's going on?" You know, and so Jesus calms the waters, and they go to the other side, and that little event in Matthew 8 ends with the disciples having seen Jesus calm the waters. They say, "What sort of man is this?" That's how that section ends. With the says the disciples said among themselves, "What sort of man is this?" Now today we have the next time he's calming the waters. This is from the 14th chapter of Matthew, and as you recalled from a few minutes ago, he's down there on the water, but he says to his disciples, "You go ahead across. I'll see you later. You go ahead and cross. I'm going to stay here and pray a while." And so they head across the sea, and a big storm comes up. A huge storm comes up, and they think, "We're going to drown. This is terrible." And they're praying, they're asking God's help, when they look out across the water and they see something coming. And they say, "It's a ghost. It's a ghost." And then Peter realizes, no, it's the Lord. And he goes to the Lord, and Jesus says to him, "Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid." And if you look through the scriptures in the New Testament, there's actually 19 times, there's 19 times when Jesus says, "Do not be afraid." 19 times, think of that. 19 times Jesus says to us, "Don't be afraid." And Peter isn't sure. He looks at the shore. "Maybe I ought to make a run for it," because he starts out walking across the water to Jesus, and then the water gets rougher, and he's not sure which way to go, but finally he comes to Jesus, and then suddenly they're all across, and they're all okay. And this time they say, "Truly, you are the Son of God." Remember what they said the first time? The first time when he walked on the waters, they said, "Who is this? What sort of man is this?" They've learned something, haven't they? They've grown in Christ. Because this time they say, "Truly, you are the Son of God." Remember, though, what Jesus says over and over and over. "Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid." This is not just a suggestion. This is not Jesus saying, "Hey, think about it this way. I'm around, so things will probably be okay." No, Jesus says, and he says it over and over and over to us, "Do not be afraid." That's not just a thought of Jesus. That's a command of Jesus. That is what Jesus commands us. "Trust me. You must trust me. You must believe that I am with you, and I'm going to watch over you, and I'm going to take care of you." And so, with all the modern problems of our society, right now we're going through this big problem that's caused a lot of turmoil, but we've been through others. The first one I remember, going back, I remember when my brother, my older brother, 14 years older than me, left to go in the Second World War, and he was gone most of the time for the next 4 years. And that was a fearful time for many people. How many people had sons that were gone and never came back? But Jesus at that time said too, "Do not be afraid." And so Jesus tells us today, "Do not be afraid. Behold, I am with you always." And these are not just calming words. When Jesus says, "Do not be afraid," that's just the same as when he said, "Thou shalt not kill." This is a commandment of the Lord. I call upon you. If you're going to follow me, you can't be afraid. You have to trust in me. And I think, very simply, that's what the Lord is calling for us to be right now in this particular drama that's taking place all around the world. "Do not be afraid," Jesus says. "Behold, I am with you." Jesus is with you. Jesus is with me and you. He is with us always. He says, behold, I am with you always. Do not be afraid. Trust me. Trust me. Now let's profess our faith in the Lord and our trust, our spiritual trust in the Lord. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. Now let us present to the Lord our own prayers of petition, trusting in his love.
That Pope Francis, through his calm and encouraging words, will bring to the Church and to the world in this time of the COVID-19 pandemic the comfort of Jesus, and so destroy fear and restore hope to every apprehensive heart. We pray to the Lord. That on this International Day of the World's Indigenous People, we will respect and value the traditions and culture of our own Native Americans, and that across the globe, all Indigenous people will have the opportunity to grow spiritually, have their gifts respected, and their human needs met. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who feel failure or inadequacy when experiencing the storms of daily life, that they encounter God's love like the freshness of a gentle breeze and respond to this encounter with an open heart, we pray to the Lord. Our Respect Life focus for the month of August is racism. Open our hearts to be vessels of hope and justice in a world inundated with violence and injustice. Give us the courage to never stand on the sidelines as we witness injustice, but walk with eyes open to the needs of our communities, with ears open to the needs of our world, with hands open in helpful service to all of our neighbors. Let us pray to the Lord. That we may recognize God's love like the freshness of a gentle breeze in both the extraordinary and ordinary events of our lives, so that we may respond with an open heart, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and those sinking in the waters of physical pain or fear, may Christ, the divine physician, calm them and grant them peace of mind. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the recently deceased members of our parish, including Barbara Lauber, mother of Dave Lauber, and all souls who have been lost at sea, they will pass over the waters of death and eternal life. And also for ourselves, the people dedicated to our nation, to our patron, St. Peter, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, We do thank you for all the blessings you give us, and we know that you will give us perhaps not what we want always, but what you know to be good for us. So, Lord, continue to watch over us and keep us safe. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, your Almighty Father.
May the Lord put the sacrifice into your hands.
Praise the Lord in his name.
Our King of all the Church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of salvation. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now we possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the paschal mystery. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until he come, again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognize the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Gather that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Peter, our patron, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession your presence, we rely for your unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Robert our administrator, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the vision of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer to one another a sign of Christ.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. and we make our prayer of spiritual communion on behalf of all those who are joining us in worship this morning. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most pleasant sacrament. I hope, I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you have already come and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Here I am, standing right beside you. and the face of every child. I am here in every warm embrace. I am here with tenderness and mercy. Here I am. I am here. Here I am, standing right beside you. Here I am. Do not be afraid. Here I am, waiting like a lover. I am here. Here I am. I am here in the midst of every trial. I am here in the face of despair. I am here when pardoning your brother. Here I am.
Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just two announcements to pass along to you before we depart Holy Mass. You'll notice our Knights of Columbus are back with the red and white Campbell soup cans. They're collecting cash donations, as they always have been, for our sister parish, Saints Teresa and Bridget, in North County. And the cash they bring in is used to purchase food directly to supply that food pantry. And the needs, as you can imagine, are overwhelming now with the COVID. Second, our ACA continues to progress well, and to those of you who've already donated, I sincerely thank you. Your gifts are already making a huge difference throughout the Archdiocese. And if you'd still like to give, and if you're still able to give, please do so by consulting the bulletin, the website, and go to the ACA website online. Thanks again.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
His name, sing the praise.